Good morning, church family. I just wanted to hop on this morning because I was having this experience with myself, and I realized that so many times on social media, we have this kind of veneer of lots of highs and lots of successes, and I don't want to pretend like that's real life. So this morning I was feeling super depleted, just a big weekend of travel, a big weekend of ministry, and I've learned over the years that whenever there's a huge outpouring of love and goodness and God is on the move, there's often like a big dip for people who are in leadership in those roles. And that's a really emotionally like vulnerable space to be in. And so coming out of that and thinking through that, what I realized that I was preaching about this weekend, but is also so true for me and for my life, is this great, great need we have to engage with one of the fundamental truths of scripture that is so easy to forget. And that truth is that we are all poor. We are poor. And Matthew 5:3, when Jesus opens his mouth to teach his climbing companions, as it says in the Message, when the people around him are gonna hear how he's about to describe what it's like to live in this kingdom that he's the king of, this invisible kingdom that we're in right now. And the very first thing he says is, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven." And we are not people who like to be poor. We wanna be rich. We wanna be rich in success. We wanna be rich in material things. We wanna be rich in relationships. We wanna be rich in strength, like inner strength. And we love to follow people who make us believe that we can be more and that we can have more and do more and all that. And all of that really is good. I mean, I feel like I'm a person who's sending that message sometimes, whether I know it or not. But in reality, the blessing comes from the poverty of spirit, from actually being able to engage and say, this is where I actually am. This is who I am right now. This is where I am right now. And accurately naming that place of need and just sitting with your Heavenly Father who loves you in that place of need, not trying to solve the place of need, not trying to give God all your plans for how to get through that place of need, but actually just being able to say, God, I'm heartbroken, I'm lonely, I'm whatever, I'm depleted, I'm empty, whatever those feelings are, being able to name that emotional space with real honesty and saying, God, I need you to meet me here. Like, I am poor in spirit, I am poor in this. I'm poor in faith. So often I think that we feel that our faith has been slipping away, our ability to believe in more, our ability to hope for more, our ability to bring the best of ourselves to other people begins to slip away in the weariness of the world. And that's where God wants to meet us. He doesn't need you to come and bring your plan and your agenda or somehow get it together before you come to be with him. He actually wants you to come in your place of need. And we try to avoid places of need so much that it really takes a discipline to accurately name how you're actually doing with your Heavenly Father. Do you know that you can never be too needy for your Heavenly Father? Like, there is no such thing as too much with him. And that means that we can bring 100% reality to the feet of Jesus. We can bring 100% reality to the throne of grace. And the way that we do that is just by being quiet enough and still enough to be able to sit with God, to name what that is, and then just to let God love you in that place. That is how we actually experience the kingdom of heaven. Then we do experience abundance. Then there is more, and we are refreshed and renewed and restored and healed in his presence. But without the reality check, the part where we actually name our poverty, it is, in my experience, impossible to experience the riches and the abundance. So I hope that helps you guys this morning. Thank you for being such an amazing group of people. Send me a DM if you have questions. I'd love to answer your questions in any way I can. I'm here to be encouraging to you. So I'll see you guys later. Peace.